郑总干事先
阿
看
弥陀
病
佛，
啊，
嗯，走吧。
诸位长辈啊，诸位同修，大家晚上吉祥啊，阿弥陀佛。
弥陀佛，对。
阿弥陀佛。
Fellow Uncle James, the president of NSW, Amitabha Associations, and fellow brothers and sisters of Dharma, good evening.
今天很高兴又跟我们雪梨的同学们老中青三代应该都有大家又聚在线上，这个也很感谢时间也很快我们相见了到现在
两
又
个月了，
经过2个多月了。
对呀，是吧？
哎，当时候感谢大家，方方面面的照顾。
It's been 2 months since we last met. I'm very, very, very happy to see each other again, to see our Sydney Dharma brothers and sisters. Again, time has passed. It's been 2 months, and now we're here having this session.
今天。这个迪伦样子很专业好像播音员一样。
我买下来了。This
好，
is, but remember, say I look professional because of the microphone.
很专业这个老祖宗说"工欲善其事，必先利其器"我们先感谢他这么用心
师傅谬赞谬赞。So thank you, Venerable, for giving me encouragement to continue to do the best of my job as translator. 阿弥陀佛。
上次到雪梨跟大家有一起学习的机会对于我们很多长辈们他们闻到佛法都非常珍惜。非常认真用功，而且跟随我们郑总贤康利还有道场长期几十年学习这个都是非常难得的因缘所以相信我们坚持下去呢，可以同生极乐国当然老中青三代都是那对于。上一次去有2次机会跟我们这些青年团的年轻朋友们大家有交流的机会真的也是很欢喜因为一个家也好，一个团体也好都要靠我年轻人。来乘船，来接棒，看到这么多年轻人都学佛，而且也很积极，在深入，也希望把佛法，能够用在他的生活、工作、处事待人接物当中，所以，这是。在佛菩萨的加持下，我们有因缘大家一起探讨佛法，所以这个现在回来2个多月有点想念大家所以跟大家再见见面互相学习，
是我们想念你啊！
好，谢谢谢谢。
阿弥陀佛，谢谢师父。So today, we have people of all, age group, coming together, gathering together, to listen, to share about the Dharma. It's to thank Uncle James and Auntie Cynthia and everyone in the Amitabha New South Wales, for all their effort, you know, their blood, sweat, and tears all these years. They pour into this association so that everyone can have this environment. I believe that no matter what stage are we in our life, we all have a stronger and we get stronger and get better in our vow to be born in Pure Land. That is a certainty. So young people is very important in propagation of the Buddha Dharma. We do rely on our next generations to pass on these wisdoms. And these wisdoms of the Buddha can be used not just in temple, but it can be used in our daily life, in our work. And this won't happen without the blessings from the Buddha and Bodhisattvas, without the protections, without the convenience that given by them, whether we can see or not. So it's been 2 months since I met you all in Sydney, and I do honestly miss you all. That's why I would like to borrow this chance, take this opportunity to gather with everyone again. So Uncle James say, we miss you too as well. I believe he spoke on our behalf very truthfully. Thank you.
这个大家方便的话呢，都可以打开镜头啊，这见面三分情啊，大家不要害羞啊。
Please feel free to open your camera because you know, able to see each other in eye to eye, face to face is more how to say, helps to for us to exchange our heart easily, so, our thoughts and our hearts.
好，我们这个学佛过程啊，偶一大师有说，善有为依呀，依众靠众，所以我们有这个一段时间啊，大家在线上啊，可以就我们在生活、工作、处事、待人接物当中实际我们遇到的问题。我们怎么用佛法来解决，大家可以探讨啊。这个就像老祖宗说的，要如切如磋，如琢如磨啊，大家一起切磋琢磨啊，可能透过大家的切磋的集思广益的啊，对一件事情呢看得更深啊，看得更全面。那我们一起相聚就大家就增广见闻了。这个见识远见都透过大家的探讨能够有所提升了。所以佛法是觉悟之法，觉悟了任何事情都能解决，都能往好的地方发展。这个是我们首先呢要有的信心啊。
阿弥陀佛，谢谢师父。So, Venerable Master O Yi has a teaching that can be used in daily life, and we can use these teachings of Buddhism to solve our daily problems. Every issues like what we do right here can be discussed in group, because if we put it out there in a group, everyone has a different experience, ideas, perspectives.And sometimes, if we put it out there in the open and allowing everyone to talk about it, discuss about it, you will often see, you know, either the people find a different spot that you might not discover if you're on your own. Sometimes the clash of ideas might give birth to a new solutions, to a new pathways, to the new ways of thinking, to the new ways of moving forward. It helps.To improve ourselves. Remember, Buddhism is all about awakening. And awaken, once we awaken, every problem we met will have a solution. Nothing is insurmountable. Amitabha.
好，那看大家有没有要提出来的问题。
Question time, guys.
或者你最近学习的 法喜喜悦，也可以跟大家分享。
Or the joys, or the afterthoughts, or the reflection of what you have experienced recently. Doesn't have to be question, it can be sharing what you have experienced recently.
这也算法布施啊，法布施的聪明智慧。
If you share it out there, you are giving the Dharma to everyone, and the giving of Dharma means the gaining intelligence.啊，我就抛砖引玉啊，师傅，没人开始我就来了。好，I'll start. Hopefully, we can bring out more ideas. 师傅好，阿弥陀佛，
阿弥陀佛，
感恩啊，首先感恩您啊，能在这边百忙中为我们开讲啊。那迪伦也不是问题，也是感想啊，就是刚刚旅游了三个星期啊，总觉得。奔波奔来奔去，虽然很漂亮，风景很好，但是总觉得心里面永远没有底，永远是浮躁的。这次旅游呢，感觉就是说，不管你跑到多远啊，天涯海角，一个人啊，如果没有一个怎么讲，主心主轴，他的人生中间没有一个主干了、啊，他都是会永远感觉不到快乐。不到满足，不管风景有多漂亮，人事物有多美好，心里面如果是漂浮不定的，永远都会很浮躁。好的事情也会变得不那么好，坏的事情会变本加厉。当然也有冷静的时候，但是就觉得这样奔波一次，就会觉得很累，觉得这个人生有时候就是我们忙来忙去，到底忙到什么时候？就算玩也会觉得很忙，所以什么时候才能定下来？那怎样才可以说在这种动来动去的社会里面，这个比较动荡的社会，或者是比较动荡的生活方式能找到一个定心丸？谢谢师父。
好，这个。迪伦呢？他出去旅游哈、三个星期，他的心得啊，他觉得心还不是很安啊、那当然，我们听到这里啊，也是要问问我们自己的心啊。安不安？到底我们比方说我们出去玩的目的是什么？或者我们人生，我们每一天都在努力呀、工作的时间也蛮长的了，到底我们的目标是什么？目的是什么？这可能我们要很清楚、假如我们每天很努力，但都不知道目标在哪里，那这个心也会比较茫然。这个中国字啊，挺有味道的啊。这个茫然的茫啊。有好几个写法，这个忙字第一个是忙，很忙了，左边一个星，右边一个王啊，忙的不知道为什么，就好像星死了，忙，在那里太忙，忙到每天一天过一天，哎呀，怎么一个月又过去了，一年又过去了，很茫然啊、到底我这么忙有没有意义啊？这个第二个忙啊，茫茫人海啊，那个忙啊，最后忙到最后看不清楚人生了， 意义何在的，最后就眼盲的盲了。那我们都知道人生难得啊，佛法难闻啊。假如最后忙到最后都不知道在忙什么，这个就很可惜了。所以像喜欢旅游的人，他一定是希望借由旅游找到快乐啊。所以这个快乐啊，应该是人所追求的。都希望幸福快乐啊。但我们一般要找快乐呢，都是向外找。好像外面会给我们快乐。孔子在《论语》里面呢，讲的第一句话呢，学而时习之，不亦说乎？他不是从外面哦，他是学了之后，实习之呢，那个习是去例行了，他会快乐喜悦，他那种喜悦呀，是从内而外出来的。举个例子啊。比方说他今天了解到老法师说的念念为他人着想，这个道理他懂了他去做了，他从今天开始的替人家着想了，做着他内心有喜悦的，他体会到助人为乐了，助人快乐这个不是别人给我的，是我做的过程啊，我自己内心里面出来了，所以真正的乐它是从内而外出来的。但是我们都误会呢，这个快乐是要从外面来，从外面来叫刺激，然后刺激一下持续不了太久啊，所以刚刚迪伦有说好事也不是那么好啊。就好像刺激一下，好像觉得哎呀挺好，但是呢，这个内心还是空虚，不是很安。讲的有点长了，迪伦你翻译一下。
谢谢师傅，我就从问题，然后再翻到师傅的答案，一起那just now I ask, I went for two-three weeks travel in overseas.I say that it's beautiful sceneries, but sometimes all this, you know, hustle and bustle, rushing off one after another locations would make me felt that everything is too a bit pointless sometimes. Like it's beautiful, but just for one moment. But after that, I felt empty. I felt lost. I felt like sometimes, you know, I don't.Like it's not what you expected, or you know, you feel tired. All these sensations coming in. So I'm asking this, and then I extrapolate into sometimes in our life, you know, we're busy traveling, busy working, busy taking care of families, etc., etc. At the end of all this, you know, what's the point of it?You know, like after one event after another, it never ending, like, trains of stuff to do. But, you know, but we like beneath this current, what is the point? You know, what is the point where we can settle down, where we actually find our anchor? And Venerable answered that first thing we need to ask ourselves, is our heart settled?Is our heart at peace? Settle in a way, is our heart at peace? Say, if you're going to travel or going to work, what are the goals? You're doing that, right? There must be a need for something for you to do these activities. These activities also is taking a lot of time in our lives. You know, like travel, it takes weeks. You go to work 8 hours at least every day. Venerable has bring out three Chinese words which I just pop up in chats to drive the point home of, you know, what busyness really means, really is. First thing, Chinese word mang, as you can see in the top, is a combination of heart and death. That means your heart is dead. Basically, you felt fatigue or you felt pointless because you keep busy, like you start working and you don't have time for, you know, turning the attention inwards. So your heart is dead. Number two is you felt lost because you're not pointing the attention inwards. You felt lost. The second Chinese word refers to lost. First one is busy. Second is lost. Mang. They are all the same Chinese pronunciation, but different meanings. If you look at the third one, in the end, very end, we felt lost to a point where we cannot see our self anymore, our life anymore. Where are we going with this? Mang, like, which is blind. So first one is busy, second one is lost, third one is blind. Our eyes, we cannot see where are we going anymore. It's so now we need to go back to ourselves, our life. It's very hard to be a human, and it's even harder to be a human who heard Buddhism. So it gets harder and harder as we get there. And at this rare opportunity of being a Buddhist human who are Buddhist, who listen to Dharma, it gets us to think, like, what really matters. And so going back to my question, if people like to travel, it's because they found joy in traveling. And joy, happiness, is the pursuit, default pursuit of every humankind, no matter where you came from, what your background is. Happiness is something that we all pursue after, you know. But what kind of happiness is that, right? We still need to be busy in our daily business, but it should be something that makes us happy, even though it's very busy. Not something that makes us blind, busy, and lost. So busy but happy, but busy with a sense of purpose, busy with a sense of joy. And Confucius has said a very beautiful word. When you learn something and you put it in practice, your joy just come out, flush out, rush out from inside. So the joy of applying what you learn in daily life comes from the inside. So this very famous word from Confucius, analect, says that our joy is found from the inside by pointing inwards. For example, Master Ching Kong say, care about others all the time. Always, 念念为大家着想, always think about others all the time. From the beginning, might feel reluctant, but as you get deeper and deeper into this practice, all right, and you put action to this teachings of caring about others, the joy comes out. You're just simply being happy by looking at others being happy. And you can be busy, very busy taking care of them, but you're very happy while doing it. That's why we are busy. That's what we should be busy for. But Venerable Chanda has emphasized, if the joy we found from outside, it's called excitement, 刺激, excitement, like pleasure, essentially pleasure. It's not long-lasting, like beautiful scenery, beautiful moment, but it's not, it cannot be sustained. And Venerable, stop here because give me the space to translate.
当然迪伦啊，他刚刚提到，他出去旅游啊，但是还是感觉心不是很安，那这样的一个体会啊，观察，自我的观察，这个就已经是很有善根了。 一般的人呢，他假如说出去旅游，感觉好像这个快乐还不是很能保持，他就可能要跑更多的地方，到更多地方去旅游，去 shopping， 他可能是用这样的方法来解决，好，就是可能让那个刺激啊更强烈，看能不能真正的心安，看能不能有一个长远的快乐。一般人看事情啊，没有办法看得那么深，看得那么根本。但迪伦他完了之后，他是看他的根本，他的心是不是真正安定了很幸福了他有观察到这里，所以因为他觉得他心不安，所以他会去找方法来安心一般的人还不见得会思考这个问题，哎。